population is dependent only on the part of a key, but not the entire key. So now this relation is not in again 2NFA. Now it can be got in 2NFA because this is called as a partial dependency. So for a relation to be in 2NFA, take out the partial dependency and put it in a new table. The partial key, make it as a primary key in the new table, which is this. The partial key was made as a primary key, and this city is a foreign key to this table here. I hope you understood. In the few more classes, we'll take some more examples on this and your doubts will be solved. Okay, thank you.
Good morning, students. Today I'll be starting with the topic backtracking. So we have completed 4 units and this is the starting of 5th unit. Now the 5th unit has 3 different programming design strategies. That is, the first design strategy is backtracking, and in this unit we will be discussing about backtracking, branch and bound, and string matching algorithms. So to begin with, backtracking is one of the design strategies. So we'll have to understand first what type of problems can be solved using backtracking. So can anybody tell me what type of problems are going to be solved using backtracking? So in backtracking, first we are going to start with, backtracking problems can also be solved using brute force method. We have already studied this particular design strategy. What do we do in brute force method? Brute force method, we are going to find out all the possible solutions for a given problem. So we will have to consider all possible solutions and then we have to find out all those possible solutions in brute force method. So first let us solve a problem using backtracking. In backtracking, let us use brute force method and solve the problem and try to understand how the problems are being solved. So to understand how do we solve a backtracking problem using brute force method, let me take one example, and with this example let us try to understand this design strategy. So in this, let me take an example. Suppose if there are 3 students, boy 1, boy 2 and girl 1. These are the 3 students. Now these 3 students have to be arranged on 3 chairs. We have 3 chairs, suppose. In this, we have to arrange these 3 students. So now we know that the size of the problem is n is equal to 3. So therefore, the possibilities in which these 3 students can be arranged on these 3 chairs will be always 3 factorial. So that is, we can arrange these students on these 3 chairs in 6 different ways. So to understand which are those 6 different ways, let me explain that with an example by drawing a tree. So if we draw the tree, we can understand how these arrangements can be done for these 3 students. So while drawing the tree, this tree is called as state space tree. So we are going to draw the state space tree and try to understand how to solve this problem. So in state space tree, what we are going to do is, these 3 chairs are there. So first we assume that on first chair we will place boy 1. So suppose I say that this is the first chair and here I am placing boy 1. Boy 1 will sit, and then later on we'll have to see what can be the arrangement. So first I have placed one student, that is boy 1. Next I will place boy 2 on the second chair, and on the third chair I will place girl 1. So girl 1 will be placed here. So once I place this boy 1, boy 2 and girl 1, now there is nobody else to be placed. There are only 3 students. So we have finished the arrangement, first arrangement. So this will be our first arrangement. So now if I have to think of the next arrangement, suppose I remove this girl 1 from here, I will find out, can I place somebody else here? Now there is nobody who can be placed here. So what I have to do is, I have to remove this boy 2 also from here, and then, so after removing this girl 1 and boy 2, what I will do is, in place of boy 1, I will place boy 2 and then girl 1. So here it is girl 1. So now this is one of the solution where I have placed now first boy 1, then it is boy 2 and girl 1. This is the boy 1, boy 2, girl 1 is the first solution, and the second solution will be boy 1, girl 1 and then boy 2. So here what I am going to do is, I am going to place in the, on the second chair I will place girl 1 and boy 2 on the third chair. So this is one of the solution what I can get. Now I will have to see what can be the other solutions. So what I can do is, now here it is not possible. If I remove boy 2 and girl 1, I don't have any other possible arrangement. So what I will do is, now I will remove this boy 1 and in place of boy 1, I'll place boy 2. So when I place boy 2, I will get here boy 1 and girl 1. So here will be boy 2, and this will have again two possibilities, that is either here boy 1, girl 1, and here I'll have boy 2, and here it will be boy 1. So these are the another two possibilities, and then I will have a, then the next is, now I cannot get more possibilities with this arrangement. So now I will have to remove boy 2 and place girl 1 there. So if I place girl 1, boy 2, and then I'll get boy 2, boy 1. So if I place girl 1 on the first chair, I can place boy 1 on the second chair or boy 2 on the second chair, and then I can have here it will be boy 1, boy 2. So now girl 1, boy 1. So here it will be boy 2 and here it will be boy 1. So if you see, these are the six different possible arrangements we get. So now what I have done is, I have solved this problem and found out all the solutions without any constraints. So now what we will do is, in backtracking we are going to find out all the solutions, but the solutions are going to be found out with some constraints. So when we apply some constraints and we try to find the solution, then those problems are called as backtracking problems. In this particular problem, I have not imposed any constraints. Suppose in this problem, if I impose one constraint saying that a girl cannot sit in between two boys. The constraint is that a girl cannot sit between two boys. If this is the constraint, then I must find out how many solutions I am going to get. And those solutions what I get is going to be called as solutions what we have got is with backtracking. So in backtracking what we do is, we are not going to find out all the solutions like this. We are going to impose the constraint, and once the constraint is imposed, we are not going to further draw the tree or generate the tree. The node is going to be killed using that bounding function. So now here we have the constraint that girl cannot sit in between the two boys. So now if you look at this, every leaf node will give us a solution. So in this, if you traverse through this leaf node to the root node, we come to know that G1, B2, B1. This is the solution we get. So now here if you look, here it is going to be B2, G1 and B1. So these are the different solutions we have got. So now in this, now I will have to find out which all which path will not lead us to the solution when I impose the constraint. So now here what happens is, here I am going to see that in this case the solution is B1, G1 and B2. So here the girl is placed in between two boys. So this cannot be continued and this is going to be killed. This node has to be killed. I kill this node using bounding function. Using bounding function, I have killed this node. So now if you look at this B2, B1, G1. So this is giving me a solution because here the girl is not in between. So this will give you a solution. Whereas here in this case, this is not going to give a solution. This will be killed as the girl is placed between two boys. Killed with bounding function. So just kill this node. So we are not going to generate this further tree. And then whereas if you look at here the girl is placed on the first chair, second chair B1, third chair B2. So this will also lead to the solution. So using this state space tree, we have got a solution for this problem wherein there are three students who need to be arranged on the three chairs. So total possibilities are 6 and with the constraint we get 4 possibilities. So we say that this particular problem is solved using backtracking because we have killed this node when we come to know that this will not lead to the solution. So this is how we are going to solve the problems using backtracking. So let us try to understand which are the other problems which can be solved using backtracking. In dynamic programming we have seen that we can solve the problems which are all optimization problems. Whereas in backtracking we are not going to solve the problems which are going to be optimization problems. These problems are going to be, they are just going to give us a solution. And in this we are going to find out all possible solutions in backtracking. Instead of optimized solutions, we are going to find out all possible solutions. So in this chapter, we'll have to discuss the different backtracking examples. The first one which we will be trying to understand how to solve is the first problem is the N-twins problem. Second is the sum of subsets problem. Third is Hamiltonian cycle problem. And the fourth one is the graph coloring problem. So we are going to understand one by one all these four problems. So in today's class I have discussed about the common backtracking concept, how this same concept is going to be applied to all these four problems while solving all four problems. Let us see one by one. So now I will be explaining what do we mean by N-twins problem. So while explaining what do we mean by N-twins problem, what I am going to do is first I am going to explain what is the problem, and once you understand what is this N-twins problem, we will see how to solve it using backtracking concept. That is backtracking design strategy. Thank you. So let's understand first what is this N-Queens problem and then solve it using backtracking design strategy. So N-Queens problem, what we are doing in N-Queens problem is, we'll have to take a chessboard of size 4x4 We are taking a chessboard of size 4x4 and we are going to place 4 queens on this chessboard in such a way that no queen will attack any other queen. So they should not attack each other. So the queens have to be placed on this chessboard in a way that they don't attack each other. Suppose I say this is the solution. And then what is this solution vector? How are we going to get this solution vector? We'll have to see. Now when I say that no queen should attack each other, what is the condition? Now on a chessboard, why we have taken 4x4 chessboard? Now if we take 8x8 chess, usually it is 8x8, but in order to reduce the problem size, we have taken it as 4x4. And this can, you can understand this particular concept using this 4x4 chessboard easily, because the number of solutions what we get are going to be more and we have to find out all the solutions and try to understand this by drawing the state space tree. So first thing is that when I have to place the queens on this particular chessboard, they should not be in the same row. Suppose if I place one queen here, I cannot place any other queen in this same row. So then also I cannot place a queen in this same column. And I cannot place a queen on this diagonal. So we cannot place the queen on the same row, same column or same diagonal. That is one of the constraint to be followed while placing the queen on the chessboard. So now we'll have to see that how many checks are there. Totally there are 16 blocks, and on this 16 blocks we'll have to arrange 4 queens. That is total number of arrangements are going to be 16c4. So you can see that the number of arrangements are really going to be huge even for 4x4 chessboard. So therefore, in order to reduce these number of solutions, what we are going to do is we are going to impose the constraints. The constraints imposed are that we are not going to place any queen in the row whenever one queen is placed. That is, this particular constraint is taken care by just seeing that one queen is going to be placed in one row. So we are not going to place any other queen in the same row. And now we'll have to see that we cannot place the queen in the same column also. And we cannot place the queen in the same diagonal. So now same row, what we do is we just assume that once the queen 1 is going to be placed in the first row, queen 2 in the second row, queen 3 in the third row and queen 4 in the fourth row. So this is taken care. So now while placing, what we have to see is in the solution we are just going to write the column in which that particular queen is placed. So now this is going to be queen 1, queen 2, queen 3 and queen 4. So now if I write a number here, it will tell me that queen 1 is placed in which column. So that is taken care. And then the bounding function has to be written for checking that they are not in the same diagonal. So let us draw the state space tree for this and try to solve this problem. Let us see how many solutions are going to be there and how to find out the total number of arrangements. So first let me start with the first queen. So I assume that first queen is placed in the x1 is placed in the first row, x2 is placed in the second row, and x3 is placed in the third row, x4 is placed in the fourth row. So when we are assuming this, we have taken care of only two things, that no queen is placed in the same row and same column, but they are going to be attacked diagonally. Because if I place the first queen in the first row, second queen in the second row, I know that it is going to be attacked diagonally. So here when I place the third queen, I know that it is going to be attacked diagonally. So what I am going to do is, after placing the fourth queen, I come to know that this is attacked diagonally. So now what I should do is, I must try to change the position of this queen. But now there is no chance for me to change the position of this queen, because the queens are placed in all these columns and there is no column after this. So what I will have to do is, I will have to backtrack and change the position of the third queen. So now what I can do is, I can change the position of the third queen and place the third queen here and the fourth queen here. But if I place the fourth queen here, again the fourth queen is going to be attacked. So now what I will have to do is, I have to backtrack and change the position of the third queen as well as the second queen. So now I know that second queen can be moved to column 3. So when I move the second queen to column 3 and this third queen cannot be placed in column 2, neither column 1, neither column 4. So now there is no place for third queen to be placed. So what I do is, I will change the location of this queen. That is, after this, I am going to backtrack and change the position of first queen, which was in the first column. I am going to place it in the second column now. This will be in the second column. So when I place queen number 1 in the second column, I will have to change the location of second queen also. So second queen will be placed in the fourth column, and then I can get back this third queen to the first column. So when I get this third queen to the first column and check, and this fourth queen is placed in the third column. So here what I am going to write is, I am going to write the solution as, here when I write first column, first queen is placed in the second column, second queen is placed in the fourth column, and third queen is placed in the first column, and fourth queen is placed in the third column. So this is one of the solution we get with all the constraints satisfied. So while getting this solution, what we have done is, after placing this x4, I came to know that I cannot get a solution when I place this fourth queen in the fourth column. So therefore, I will have to change the location of this fourth queen. I had to change the location of this third queen as well. I had to change the location of second queen also. And after this, I came to know that I had to change the location of first queen itself. So what had happened was, this did not lead me to a solution. X1 equal to 1, x2 equal to 2, and x3 equal to 3. X4 equal to 4. This is not going to lead to a solution. So now I know that X4 cannot be placed in the next array. There is no space for X4 to be placed. So I have to remove X4, and X4 should be placed in third column. So what I do is, If I have to place x4 in the third column, I will have to move x3 to the second column, change the position of the x3 and x2. So what I will do is, x1 can be placed in first column and x2 can be placed in the second column, or x2 can be placed in the third column, x2 in the third column, or x2 in the fourth column. x2 in the fourth column. So whereas now when I place x1 can be placed in either first column, and then when I take x1 in the first column, x2 is going to be in the second column, third column, or fourth column. And then what I will have to do is, once I place x2 in the second, I cannot place x3 in the second. x3 should be placed in the third, and x3 should be placed in the fourth, and x4 should be placed in x3. x4 will be placed in x3 in this case. So this is what I am going to get. So similarly, even here I will get two options for, so here I will get x1 and x2 is placed, x1 is in the first, x2 is in the third. So I can place x2 in the second and x2 in the fourth. Whereas here I can place x2 in the second or x2 in the third. And so after placing x2 in the third, then what is left is x1, x2, x3. x2 is in third. So x3 will be in 2 or x3 will be in 4, x3 will be in 2 or x3 will be in 3, and x4 in this case, only x4 has to be placed. So x4 can be placed in 1, 3, 2, 4. So here if you see 1, 3, 4 and then x4 in 2, x4 equal to 2. And here if you see 1, 4, 2 and 3, x4 will be equal to 3, and here we are going to get as 1, 4, 3, 2. So x4 will be equal to 2. So these are the possible solutions when I place x1 in the first column. So with this I am going to get 1, 3. So in this, if you see how many are there, similarly now I will get a separate tree for x1 equal to 2, x1 equal to 3 and x1 equal to 4, x1 equal to 4. So like this, if you go on drawing this tree, it is going to be really a very huge tree. So if you see, total number of possibilities are going to be, first one, 1 plus 4 I get, and then I get this will be plus 4 into 3, 4 into 3, and then into 2 into 1. Okay. So 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. So like this I will get plus 4 into 2 3 plus again 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. So total it is going to be 5 plus 24 plus 12 plus 24. So total you get it as 48 plus 12 plus 5. So 65. You are getting totally 65 possibilities. You get 65 possibilities without any constraints. without any constraints we are going to get 65 possibilities. So now what we'll have to do is, in this, when I have to solve this problem using backtracking, this is using brute force method and Quinn's problem using brute force method, because of which you are getting all possible solutions. So now we'll have to find out which is the solution using backtracking. So now when I want to solve the same problem using backtracking, what I have to do is, while drawing the tree, I should know when to kill the node and which condition it has to satisfy. So I have to set a bounding function. Looking at the bounding function, we'll have to kill a node in the state space tree. So when we know that we can kill a node using the bounding function, so you will have to draw again a state, different state space tree, where you are going to kill a node as soon as you come to know that this will not lead to a solution because it is not satisfying the bounding function or the condition. So now we'll have to see how to draw the different state space. Let me cancel this. Let me draw a different state space tree with the bounding function. Suppose I start from the root node. What I'm going to do is, I'm going to start placing the first queen. The first queen I will place here in the first column. Let me take this. First queen will be in the first column. So when I place the first queen, x1 in the first column, and then x2 can be in the second column. I see that x2 can be in the second column, but I come to know that when I place x2 in the second column, this will not lead to the solution because it is not satisfying this condition that it is in a different diagonal. They both are in the same diagonal, so therefore we have to kill this node. No need to further go in this direction. So what I will do is, I cannot place the second queen in this second column. So what I will do is, I will place the second queen in the third column. Second queen in the third column. Yes, second queen can be placed in the third column. So now I will have to see, after placing second queen in the third column, I will have to place third queen. So can I place third queen? When I place this in the third column, I will have to place the third queen. Now third queen has to be placed either here, here, here or here. So I come to know that third queen cannot be placed here, neither here. So when I come to know that third queen cannot be placed in both these locations, what I will do is, I am going to do the bounding function here. This cannot be further, that is, third queen cannot be placed. So I am going to kill this node, bound this node, and then I am going to see where can I place. So x3 cannot be placed in the second column, neither in the x3 Now I can place it in the fourth column. X3 equal to 4 also not possible. So I am going to kill this here. So what I will do is I will go back. And now I cannot go further here. So I will have to go back and then move the position of the second queen. Can I place the second queen? Second queen is in the third column. So when second queen is in the third column, I am not able to place third queen at all. So what I will do is I will go to this and then try to change the position of second queen. Second queen cannot be in the second column, second queen cannot be in the third column. Then second queen can be in the fourth column. So let us see. X2 will be equal to 4. Second queen is in the fourth column. So when I take it to the fourth column, let me see. Let us take the second queen in the fourth column. So when I take the second queen in the fourth column, this will second queen in the fourth column. So then what I do is third queen can be placed in the second column. Third queen is placed in the second column. So then when I place the third queen in the second column, I have to see, can I place the fourth queen? Fourth queen, can I place it in the first, I cannot place it in the second, I cannot place it in the third, neither fourth. So here also I am not going to get the solution with the third queen in the second column. This will not lead to solution, so I am going to bound this here. So what I can do is, can I move this third queen from second column to first column? So what I will do is, I will move this X3 to first column. X3 will come to first column. So when I place X3 in the first column, I cannot place X3 in the first column. If I try to move this X3 here, it is already there in the first column. So even that is not possible. So now what I will have to do is, I will have to go back and change the position of the second queen. Now second queen position, we have explored all possibilities. So I cannot, so I will have to go back and change the position of the first queen itself. So when I change the position of the first queen and I move the first queen to second column. I will move the first queen to second column. When I move the first queen to second column, and then I will see first queen to second column, then I will have to see where I should place the second queen. Now second queen was in the fourth column. So now we'll have to check whether that is going to give me a solution. So if I place second queen in the fourth column, X2 in the fourth column, what happens is I can place X3 in the first column. So here what I'm going to do is X3 will be placed in the first column. So after placing X3 in the first column, X4 I will have to check where can I place X4. So X4 can be placed in the third column. X4 can be placed in the third column. So I can say that 1, 2, 3, 4, I have placed all the queens and this is the solution node, solution path. So this is how I get the solution path. Now I am going to get one more solution, which is going to be the mirror image of this, that is 3142.
3, 1, 4, 2. So this is going to be one more solution. So I can say that this is the mirror image of this is going to be one more solution. So 3, 1, 4, 2. This is solution 2. And this is solution 1.
What you will have to see in this is backtracking. There is one more design strategy which is called as branch and bound. So in today's class I will just explain what is the difference between these two design strategies, that is branch and bound and backtracking, because branch and bound will be covered in the different class. So today let us just try to understand the difference between these two design strategies. So I hope you have understood that these problems are going to be exponential problems, where looking at the state space tree you can see that the number of possibilities are going to increase as the number of as the size of the problem goes on increasing. So in this case we have seen there are going to be 65 possibilities. So total number of possibilities, how are we going to write here? We can write the total number of possibilities as, the equation can be written as, one plus summation of I equal to 0 to, there are 4 queens, so here we are getting total 3. So I can say that n minus 1. So I equal to 0 to n minus 1. So in case of 4 queens problem, it is going to be summation of I equal to 0 to 3 and product of n minus j, where j is equal to 0 to I. This is going to be the total number of possibilities, I can say, using backtracking. So now if you see, totally there are 4 queens. So therefore what we do is, first we place the first queen, second queen, third queen and fourth queen. So here what we are doing is, we are trying to place all the queens first and then find out. If we are not able to place, then we'll backtrack and go and change the location of the previous queen if we are not going to get the solution. So in this what we are doing is, in backtracking we just go, pre-order search is done, which is called as, it is similar to depth first search, that is DFS. In backtracking is similar to DFS, that is depth first search, whereas in case of branch and bound what we are doing is, the search is not going to be depth first, whereas we are going to follow the strategy of breadth first search. So in depth first what we do is, in branch and bound what we do is, first we find out all the possibilities where x1 can be placed. So x1 can be placed in the first column, x1 can be placed in the second column, x1 can be placed in the third column, or x1 can be placed in the fourth column. So then we see where x2 can be placed. So once I place x1 in the first column, x2 can be placed in the second, x2 can be placed in the second, x2 can be placed in the third, or x2 can be placed in the fourth. So same here also we are going to do.
and then x1, x2 is over. So x3 can be placed in the third or fourth. So now remaining is x4, so that will be only one option is left. So it has to be placed in the remaining column in which these three queens are not placed. So here if you see, it is going to be breadth first search. So first level, second level, third level, and then we are going to go to the fourth level. So in branch and bound we follow breadth first search, whereas in backtracking we follow depth first search. And so here in this, branch and bound are all optimization problems, and they are that too only minimization problems are solved using branch and bound. So now this completes the explanation of backtracking. I hope you have understood the concept of backtracking and how to solve the n queens problem using backtracking. So if you have any difficulties understanding my lecture, you can just drop in your questions on my email ID or my Google Classroom. You can drop your questions there and I'll be happy to solve the difficulties whatever you face in solving this or understanding this particular concept. So in the next class I will be solving problems on sum of subsets, Hamiltonian cycle and graph coloring. So today you have understood the concept. So understanding those three and solving will be much easy for you in the next class. So please revise this particular concept and be perfect in this so that you will understand the next topics in the fifth unit, that is branch and bound problems and string matching problems. Please go through the video and complete your 10th term work. So next class I'll be discussing the 9th term work, that is sum of subsets.
कल के ना।